Hello and welcome to the next lesson of our Strategy Lab course. Today we will look at how to choose a platform and broker, and we will show you how to set up an account where you can deploy strategies for testing using virtual money. I've got the strategies ready and prepared, but if you haven't had time to build them yet, that's okay, you've got time because we will just set up a demo account today and deploy them in the next lesson, so you still have some time. Now let's go over the basic rules that you need to know, because there are a lot of platforms out there, and the basic purpose of a platform is for you to take strategies and deploy them to the markets where they are supposed to trade. We've built a strategy on Nasdaq stock index, so we are simply using the platform to take that strategy and deploy it on the Nasdaq so that the strategy can execute trades there. You can choose from various platforms, but the most used are just a few. Most of them are connected directly to a broker. For example, like TradeStation, it's a common platform for futures trading on stock indexes, crude oil, and so on. It's both a platform and a broker. Then there are independent platforms such as Multicharts, and this one can be connected to any broker, but it is also a paid platform, so you have to pay for it. However, to start with, it's always better to take the easiest path. In our experience, that's choosing the MetaTrader 4 platform, a widely available platform where you can easily trade CFDs on stock indexes. That's why we will test strategies in this platform. It's best to start gradually, like with everything. Test the strategies on this platform and then move on if necessary. But MetaTrader 4 still has the advantage that you can trade so-called CFDs on stock indexes, so you can trade really, really small positions. You need a good broker, and if you have one, even CFDs are very nicely profitable. But beware, important information, especially for US traders. If you are trading on US territory, we strongly recommend you choose the MetaTrader 5 or TradeStation platform instead. We will show you how to deploy strategies within these platforms in the bonus lesson, using futures as an example, but the principle will be the same. Now, I will tell you something about choosing a broker and who the broker actually is. A broker is simply a company that arranges your trades. It allows you to buy or sell just that Nasdaq, for example. It's your trading partner through which you can make money. There are many brokers and you can't make it without one. But what to look out for when choosing one? Well, definitely time zones. Each Forex and CFD broker may have a different time zone. Accordingly, the opening prices on the daily or 4-hour chart differ. Most brokers today use UTC plus 2, so it's Central European Time plus 1 hour. But for example, XTB uses UTC plus 1. To give you a better idea, let me show you practically. In this platform, you see the time 10:34 p.m., but I'm recording this lesson at 9:34 p.m. So this broker uses UTC plus 2. You need to know what time your broker uses and set the data in StrategyQuant accordingly. However, we've already built the strategies with UTC 2, so you will do it the other way around and you will look for a broker that uses UTC plus 2. But as I said, almost every broker, like most of the broker, really use this time, so it's not going to be a problem. You also need to choose your broker by location. We are based in Czech Republic, so Central Europe, and we prefer to use robo markets. Outside the European Union, it's robo Forex, and as I mentioned, to US traders, we recommend using TradeStation or Multicharts.
Or you can go for Darwinex, who offers Darwinex for UK only, for European Union only, or Darwinex Global. And that's also a reason why I'm going to use this broker for a demonstration how to sign up and how to run a demo account.
Another thing to discuss is the demo account. We can use two types of accounts to test strategies. A demo account, which is an account that behaves just like a real account or should behave like that, but trades with just virtual money. So the profits and losses are not real, and therefore you can test your strategies and you won't lose any real money. Or there is option number two. You can use a real account where you already have some of your capital. If you would like to choose this second option, in any case, we would very, very strongly recommend starting with absolutely minimal capital and minimal possible positions. Never ever, for God's sake, launch a new strategy with a large amount of capital right away, because you don't know how it will behave in real trading environment or how it will fit you personally. We recommend using a demo account for CFDs, that is, for stock indexes and MetaTrader 4. We will demonstrate how to set one up today. And as I said, you need to choose a good broker. I mean, you can open a demo account with any broker, even a bad one, but then you have to remember that one day you will eventually want to switch to a real account, and with a bad broker, the rule I mentioned a moment ago, that the demo account behaves the same as the real account or should, may not quite apply. So as with everything in our lives, it's best to choose a pro and quality just right from the beginning. The ideal is, of course, to choose a broker that provides support in your native language, or at least in a language you speak very well. Please avoid brokers from countries such as Anglia and various other kind of exotic countries.
Now I'm going to show you how to open the Darwinex account. First of all, of course, go to darwinex.com and choose which version you would like to use. If you want to go to Darwinex UK, Darwinex European Union, or Darwinex Global, the very first step is to sign up. So click on the button in the right top corner, read this important notice, check this checkbox, and choose continue to Darwinex Global. Now it's time to choose your username, your email, and also your password. Choose country of tax residence and regulated entity. Accept that information are being processed by Darwinex. And click on sign up. Now you'll see welcome screen. Welcome to Darwinex. Let's configure Darwinex to offer you a personalized experience. To help us get to know you better, kindly respond to the following questions. It will only take a minute. So let's begin. What would you like to do at Darwinex? So choose what we'd like to do. Which assets would you like to trade? You can choose whatever you want. And also, what trading platform do you currently use? I'm going to stick to MetaTrader 4. And now there is a last question, I guess. Can you help us grow? Tell us where you met us. So you can choose, for example, by recommendation. It's up to you. It's not important part. Right at this point, you can choose to try out their demo. First of all, again, we have to choose demo account name. I choose currency, USD, and initial virtual money. You can choose whatever value you like. Now you can see congratulations screen. Your demo Darwinex MT4 trading account has been created. I've just heard that I've got an email with all the information I will need. Also, I do recommend to make a screenshot of this screen, because they are all needed information to connect to server. So my recommendation is make a screenshot and save it. Now the next step is to download MT4 terminal. I will open the installation file right away. And now I have to wait. After just a few seconds, there is a congratulations and you can choose to finish the installation. Now you can see that the terminal is already opening itself. And right now is the moment where we are going to need all the information I told you to screenshot from your computer display. So let's find it and let's fill it. So I'm going to type my login and the password. Just note, it's not the password you have chosen while you were signing up. It's the password that Darwinx sent to you to your email and that show you on that screen I told you to screenshot. Server is Darwinx demo and choose to log in. And we are in.
I look forward to seeing you in the next lesson where we will already deploy the strategies on our demo account.